Oh, you can see me. Hello. Hiya. I didn't realise it was that reflective. So I've got our brand new Samsung fridge freezer. And I'm really, really chuffed because it's got a water dispenser. This is going to be so useful in the summer. And for me, because I'm always warm, I am going to be using this all the time. So I'm really chuffed with the water dispenser on the front of the fridge freezer. I can't get a good view because our kitchen's really narrow. So this is what it looks like. So it's a bit smaller height-wise than our last one, but that doesn't matter because I'm not bothered about that. Let's have a look inside. We've not turned it on yet because it's only just arrived and you've got to leave it for 3 to 4 hours to adjust. Right, inside we've got a stuck down glass shelf, but this one's a good easy slide one, which it would, but it's still taped in. But this slides out. Then we've got another stuck in shelf. Got an egg holder, but I don't keep eggs in the fridge, but it's there anyway. And then we've got our bottom one here, which is our fruit and veg thing, isn't it? Which I don't eat any fruit and veg, so this is probably going to be full of condiments, you know, starters you mean to go on. And inside, that's the bottle holder in there, that wire bit. And this hooks on underneath this, or any other shelf you like, except for this one. And that's good for like big bottles, so that'll be for my Coke Zero or Dr. Pepper. Right, on the door, we've got the top shelf, which is probably going to be used for more condiments. This is the water tank for the front dispenser, and it's 4.5 litre. I don't know how many flozzies that is, America. I'm sorry, when it comes to liquids, I prefer metric. The only imperial measurements I do is when I'm weighing myself, because smaller numbers are better numbers. So I'm 16 stone. Another little one there. I don't know what I'm going to use this for. This is a very small, very, very small shelf. Don't know what that's going to be used for. Then we've got the bottom one, this one, which is probably where the milk's going to go. That's the thing, look, it's A+. Energy thingamajig. And yeah. Oh, is that the Samsung number? RB29FWRNDSS. Yeah. Oh, well, at least... Oh, yeah, it's the serial number I gave you before, wasn't it? So that's the fridge part of it. Look, I like it how it shows you what's meant to go in there. But for me, that is definitely not what'll be going in there. Are you supposed to keep carrots in the fridge? I've never kept carrots in the fridge. And that could be either broccoli or cauliflower. But it looks like a cloud with a stalk on it. Right, let's have a look at the freezer a bit. It smells lovely and new. Have a good smell for you to YouTube. Get your nose to the screen and smell the newness of plastic and chemicals. Fabulous. Right, so we've got 3 drawers. So this is where it gets smaller than our last fridge freezer, because our last one had 4. But we never really had it that full anyway. But these drawers are actually a bit bigger. Right, so inside, what's this? A very small ice cube tray. I don't think I'll be using this one because it looks like a very hard plastic one, so it's going to be impossible to get the ice cubes out of that. Once again though, no light in the freezer. I don't know why. What is so impossible about having a light in the freezer? Am I missing something technical here of why every freezer doesn't have a light in it? Anyway, so in there it recommends chicken, fish and pizza with a slice taken out of it. That's the recommended serving suggestion. And it's another full open box there. I mean, these lovely, nice and capacious drawers. I love the word capacious. And on the bottom one, oh, it's the same pictures again. And these drawers are pretty much, yeah, all the same length backwards, which is nice. So that's that. It just says full open box on the back of the door. And it says on the bottom, below minus 18. So that shows you how long you're meant to keep stuff in a freezer. But of course, when you freeze things, you know, once it's frozen, it's frozen. I think we all keep things in there a bit longer than we should. So that's the light there. So that'll be coming on when it's turned on. So let's turn it on and see what it looks like all lit up. Our new Samsung fridge freezer. There's me again. Ah, yeah. Well, now this is... Right, it got delivered at 7:15. And the delivery people were really nice and helpful. And nice and quiet for the neighbours as well, because the sound for this flats is ridiculous. And the rule was it had to be, what, 4 hours did it have to rest?
3 hours.
3 hours. Well, it's been way more than that, so it should be well and adjusted now. So now we're going to plug it in. And, ooh, new fridge here. Plug, charge, thank you. There's the hidden things behind fridges. I have to bring it forward. There we go. Right, so it's plugged in.
Is it not switched off at the fuse box?
It's switched off still at the fuse box, yeah. So probably already put on a caption, because I gave out the serial number rather than the model number. So it's RB29FWRNDSS. And we're just about to turn it on. Yay! Oh, there I am again. Hello! You see my reflection. So let's have a look inside. Woo! That's bright. So it's LED lights. I'm assuming that when it's full, it's gonna... But I'm putting my hand right in front of it now, and it's still giving off loads of light, so I don't think that's gonna be a problem. Because that's the thing with LED lights, isn't it? So, this is the easy slide drawer. Ages taking bits of tape off and everything. Little marks left by the tape and everything. And I should wash this, shouldn't I, before I use it? Because I don't know how clean inside this is going to be. And this is it looks like it's flashing maybe on your screen. But that's just because the refresh rate, it really isn't flashing like that. It's flashing on my LDC screen, but this is absolutely not flashing. And this is absolutely not flashing either. So it's just a refresh rate on the camera, I think, that's making that do that. And the LED's affecting the thing as well. So it's on minus 19, which the man in John Lewis said that's what it should be on, between 19 and 21, because you don't really need to go the full minus 23. And then the fridge is like 3 degrees, which is fine. Your fridge should never really be at 7, really. It should always be under 5, your fridge. Between 1 and 5, really. So that's everything for the fridge. Once again, I've already said, but why can't we have a light in the freezer? Why? In the 21st century, we're supposed to put up with the darkest depths of freezing. So this is bright now because there's now in it, but as soon as it's full and on a night time, that's going to be a bit of a pain. Maybe it's something for fridge freezer manufacturers to look into. Oh, it's beeping. That's because that's the sound it makes when you've left the door open. So I'm going to shut the door now and then it chill. So I'm going to test the water dispenser now. So it does have a lock feature on it. So if you've got any kids in the house or anything, you can lock it off so there's no accidental pressing. Unless your kids figure out how to use that, which they probably will, and then forget to put it back, and then the younger kid comes through and still floods it. Anyway, let's have a look. Mm, that's good, isn't it? Mmm, refreshing! Oh, that's really good. I like that. That's really useful. It does say on the inside, only use water, it says in this somewhere. It's hard to see. So, but if you want, you can, I suppose, put vodka or gin in it. If you want to squeeze that in there. I think what it means is don't put anything like dilute juices in anything because it'll go mouldy and bleh. But I don't see why I'm putting vodka or gin in it.
Well,